Episode 11 of Sailor Moon is my favorite from the whole first season. It has everything that makes the show great and more. We get a lot of tension between our girls. Rei fights with Usagi. Waddell sidelines her official spoiled little princess.
It's a bear!
Usagi, get off of that!
What was that for?
We get to see our Sailor Guardians go to amusement park, while Luna reminds the voice of reason and tries to guide them towards building a better team.
Unbelievable!
Honestly, what were you thinking, Usagi?
As I mentioned before, I don't like Ami that much. She's a silent, study-focused type. Yeah, she has little to no confrontations with the slob, uneducated, and undisciplined Usagi.
Get your act together! You call yourself a Sailor Guardian!
Hey, don't you lecture me!
They're complete opposites, and yet they seem to get along. That's not the case with Rei. She's made out of fire and passion, and any act of disobedience is strongly criticized by her.
Isn't this the cutest little bunny?
And make a bet that thing's smarter than you are.
Why are you always so mean?
The show finally managed to get that shonen rivalry going, and I kinda like the way Usagi and Rei keep on arguing about every action or idea they disagree upon. Another strong factor in their relationship is that they are also in love with the same dude. I'm talking about none other than Tuxedo Mask.
Hey there, you girls need a ride? Hop on!
Tuxedo Mask, you're here!
Wow, he's really cool.
The classic man who gets all the ladies.
Yay, it's Tuxedo Mask!
Wow, how stunning!
With his dark, mysterious allure and clean gentleman attire.
You can be mean when you look this clean. I'm a classic man. Calling on me like a young OG. I'm a classic man. Your knees get made by the street. Elegant, old-fashioned man. Yeah, baby, I'm a classic man.
He's so tall and handsome, not to mention hard to get, which drives girls wild.
It's a trap! Come on!
There's no better example of his allure in this very episode.
Farewell.
Huh? Where's Tuxedo Mask?
Oh boy.
Usagi and Rei are trapped in a fantasy world, and their most desired scenario is a date with Batman. Tuxedo Mask. I keep on confusing these two.
Farewell for now.
Tuxedo Mask!
Sailor Moon is a show built on witty dialogue and thematic character interactions. Not to mention interesting magical scenarios and colorful visuals.
I don't believe it! She's also a guardian?
What is this? What's happened to me?
Well, all these aspects are at their best in this very episode. From the engaging dynamic of our Sailor Guardians to their captivating fun interactions with Tuxedo Mask. Rei and Usagi even managed to meet Mamoru on a children's park team train, where they exchange some heated dialogue.
You again? Why are you here?
Hey, hold on. That's the first thing out of your mouth after headbutting someone?
Well, our blonde bimbo is the one who is in conflict with the guy. Although I gotta admit, it is Mamoru who is a bit too mean with her. Ever since they first interacted with each other, tall and handsome has been nothing but sarcastic and distant towards Usagi.
30%? Looks to me like you better study harder next time, Bunhead.
Well, that's none of your business!
The blonde-clad blonde-maid character might be a bit clumsy and undisciplined, but she does not deserve such cruel treatment from an initial stranger. I guess Mamoru and Tuxedo Masks were built to be as opposite personality, to create some conflict within the love story. Basically, Bruce Wayne is mean towards Selina Kyle, while Batman is beloved by Catwoman. Rather simplistic and obvious parallel, since in the animated series, Selina is kind of uninteresting in bros, while Batman is mean towards Catwoman. But I guess you get my point. This time, however, it is Usagi who delivered the last line. He even manages to put Mamoru in his place, despite having to fight against Rei as well.
Don't you have any friends your own age? Or are you just looking for someone on your puny mental level to talk to?
It's no secret Sailor Moss is kind of mean towards Sailor Moon, and with this unexpected occasion of meeting Mamoru, Rei has gotten a few cool laughs alongside him.
Bunhead, that's classic, and it fits you perfectly.
Now she looks like a steamed bun.
That's a good one.
This episode is so amazing, using Marmaro and Toxicity Mask in the same scenario. It's not as soft as it might seem. There are instances when Sailor Moon only interacts with Tuxedo Mask for a brief moment, as he saves her from danger with his classic roses. On episode 11, we have Rei and Usagi talk with Marmaro and flirt with their beloved crush.
Wait for me!
Stick to dreaming only when you're asleep.
This is a rare opportunity which further develops both our Cell Guardians relationship and their very superficial and unconditional romance with their handsome Cape Crusader. I also appreciate the panty shots in this episode. Another reason I hold it in such high regard is the glimpse of perversion and fanservice scattered throughout the scenes. If you blink, you might miss top score shots, but isn't it fast enough to deceive my trained eyes? I get two instances where we see them wipe pennies, once on both Usagi and Rei. While the main attraction and the most iconic scene with Sailor Mars has her lift her miniskirt in her awesome fire signature attack.
Evil spirits! Be exorcised!
Despite all these highlights moments of the series, the main story does not drive away that far from the standard repetitive premise of the show. Even though Demi is kinda cheesy and tries to get away with being silly way too many times, Sailor Moon is still self-aware of its established parameters. Acknowledges the importance of their reference. It even makes the cat as aware of certain obvious aspects of their life. For example, the evil witch lady has well seen notice the endless streak of defeats and disappointments of her knight, and has been rather outspoken in her rage. Also, it is so damn obvious Mamoru is actually a Tuxedo Mask, and for a small girl like Rei not to notice this striking resemblance would have been completely out of her established traits and character. Therefore, she kinda hints to Usagi. And she suspects her mean brunette companion might actually be the mysterious knight who throws roses and saves her life in moments of peril.
Hey, don't you think that guy in front of us kinda looks like Tuxedo Mask?
Huh? All these fun little moments before a highlight episode in the Sailor Moon series.
And you, show us your true form!
Pleased to meet you too!
Usagi!
Oh, right.